Hey, it's Fran with Little Windows. I'm going to show you how to make these beautiful color-shifting bangles. They'll look completely different depending on what kind of light is around you and what you put behind them. Here are some pieces I already made. You can use any graphics you want. On this one, I used a line from a favorite song. You can scan in images, create your own, or find stuff online. In each of these, I'm layering bold black art over the reflective, color-shifting Dichro-ISH films. See how different they look if I wear them with a black shirt. To make these, I used double-sided Bangle molds, brilliant resin, which comes with mixing cups and mixing wands. I printed my images on clear photo film, which is great with any inkjet printer. I used jumbo sheets of Dichro-ISH films, double-sided adhesive, and a large silicone doming tray. I also used a resin level to make sure that my surfaces were all completely straight. You'll find all of these supplies at littlewindows.com. So here I have my mold set out and ready to go. Step one is to cut out your strips to fit in these bangle molds. Each one has two layers. I found some graphics online and created some others and composed them on an 8.5 by 11 sheet. Then I printed that on our clear photo film. This will work in any inkjet printer. You can print patterns too and color if you want. For my projects, I'll stick to the black and white. I'll try one with this snakeskin print. Behind these graphics, I'll put a strip of Dichro-ISH film. This is a pack of Dichro-ISH films. The jumbo size is perfect for projects like this. Each pack includes two sheets each of six colors of Dichro-ISH films and two sheets of rainbow texture film. So you can make a lot of projects with these. The ones from my jumbo pack are long enough to go all the way around any bangle, and you can see how they shift in the light. You'll see here how the rainbow texture film looks when it has a black background. This is a strip Dichro-ISH film. It's the same one I used in this bangle. You can also take the flat film and crinkle it up. Just roll it around in your hands and then flatten it out again. And the texture will catch the light. You can use adhesive sheets to stick your two layers together. This film has greenish reflections. I think it'll look great behind the snakeskin print. And you can emboss these films as well. If you want to see how this is done, be sure to watch our video on embossed Dichro jewelry. You'll find the link in the description below, and also at the end of this tutorial. You can play around with these to see how they'll look when they're layered together. I really like this combination. I'm going to show you these four examples. Each one is a little bit different. I found this strip that was already cut, so I'll use this in my square mold. All four of them require strips that are 5/8 inch high, but the lengths will vary depending on which shape you're using. Now I need to cut them to the right length. In this maker's guide, there's a guide that will help you cut your strips to the perfect size to fit all four molds. First, we have our animal print. This is long enough to fit in any of the four shapes, but I think I'll put this one in our oval mold. This one has a beautiful quote and it's pretty long, so I'll put this one in our rectangle shape. That leaves this one to go in the circle. The best way to do these layered pieces is to stick your two layers together, but you can also embed each layer separately, and that's what I'll do in the circle mold. The inside layer will be the Dichro-ISH film, so I'll fit that to my mold, leaving a little bit of space around the inside, and tape the ends together. Now I'll cut the strip following the design of the pattern. And there's my inside ring. The outside strip needs to be a little bit bigger. I'll use a small piece of double stick adhesive and overlap the ends just a bit. That'll fit perfectly. I want this one to overlap just a bit too, so I'll cut it a little longer than the guide recommends. Double check that it'll fit well, and use a little piece of double stick adhesive to tape the ends together. On this strip, the words were not lining up properly inside my mold, so I'll just cut them apart. This way I can move them wherever I want them to be. Step 2 is mixing your resin. In the maker guide, it tells you how much resin you'll need to fill each mold. 30 milliliters is an ounce, so these 2-ounce mixing cups are perfect for making 2 bangles per batch. I'll pair the oval and rectangle together and the square and circle. You can use the dust covers that come with these molds or use your creation station. It's such a great tool for any craft. It protects your surface and it's movable in case space is a problem. I'm ready to mix my first batch. I've warmed up my part A. You can see it's nice and thin. It'll blend really well and any bubbles will release very easily. Mix in my part B. Stir for 2.5 minutes, scraping the sides and bottom, and let that rest in the cup for 5 minutes, so it's fully blended. Double check that your surface is level. You don't want these drying wonky. Fill your molds about 3/4 of the way. I'll insert the Dichro-ISH ring and use my mixing wand to push it down against the bottom. And pull it away from the inside edge to be sure that resin flows on both sides of the strip. I'll do the same thing here. So I want to make sure there's a coating of resin all around the inside. And then I'll put in the outside strip. Now I'll add more resin to fill these up level with the top of the mold. Now I'll insert my cut strips. Cutting them apart made it very easy for me to put them exactly where I wanted them. And push them down to the bottom of the mold. And add resin till it's level with the top. These handy wands are reusable. Just wipe them clean with a dry paper towel. If you're not comfortable pouring resin straight from your cup, try scooping it on with your mixing wand. I'm not wearing gloves in this video. Brilliant Resin is the safest epoxy you'll find, and I'm working in small, manageable batches, but I always make sure that my space is well ventilated. If you have chemical sensitivities, if you're mixing larger batches, making larger projects, or using resin frequently, make sure to protect yourself with an organic vapor mask or respirator and gloves. Open your molds and make sure they're clean before casting. And again, pour about 3/4 full. I'm going to place a seam at the end where it won't show up as much when I'm wearing this bangle. Push it down to the bottom and make sure that there's resin on both sides of the strip. And fill it up. Now for our last bangle. I decided to experiment on this one. Instead of sticking the two layers together, I left them loose and only tacked them together at one end. This made it a little difficult to wrangle these into the mold. I'll push this down to the bottom and fill it to the top. I I'm using my mixing wand to make sure that resin gets all around the outside. Cover your projects and let them set up for about 12 hours. These ones have been sitting overnight. Let's see how they came out. Oh boy. So here's what happens when you don't tape the ends together. The strips did not stay put during setup. The two strips are no longer lined up, and the front strip is sticking completely up out of the resin. Oh, that's a bummer. I really like how the lettering looks in this piece. Oh well, I'll try to salvage it. If you don't pour just the right amount of resin in these molds, the top will have a bit of a dip. This is easy to fix by adding just a bit of resin to the top. So what I'll do is trim down this film that's sticking out. I'm going to place the bangle on the doming tray and add a little bit of resin along the top edge. Let's see how our snakeskin turned out. Ooh, it's so shiny. Oh, I really like this combination. I'm going to squeeze my mold from both sides and pop it right out. Close up your mold and put it back in the package as soon as you can so that it stays clean for the next use. Ooh, look at the colors and textures. That one looks really nice. And the fill level was perfect on this one. So you can see that the top and bottom are both completely smooth. I won't have to dome this one up. If it has any little bumps, those can be easily trimmed. By using the clear photofilm over the transparent Dichro-ISH films, you get a whole lot of color and still transparency. So the light around you is going to make a big difference in how this looks. And the colors you put behind it will too. Oh, nee. Look at this one. That strip was too skinny. I didn't measure it before I put it into the mold. And you can see there's extra resin filling the top, so it does not look the way I wanted it to. This one was underfilled, so it has a little bit of a dip in the top. I'll trim off any bumps or lumps, and then dome it up with a bit of resin. Let's have a look at our cityscape with the hexagon print behind. Looks pretty good from here. Moment of truth. Dun dun. Oh, sorry this is not in focus. It's actually really pretty. The hexagon pattern on the film works so well with the cityscape. I forgot to go back and check for bubbles. I don't really mind them so much in this piece, but this one is on the outside and makes a jagged edge to my otherwise smooth bangle. I'm gonna dome the top of this anyway, and while I'm at it, I'll fix that bubble. So to fix this bubble, I'll use a little piece of our No-Residue Resin Backer Film. This works better than tape because it'll leave the finish super shiny. So I'll cut a very small piece. I'm gonna line up the top of this backer film with the top of the bangle. Step 3 is to dome any tops that are not smooth. So the first thing you wanna do is make sure that your doming tray is level. You always want a level surface when you're working with resin. Arrange these on your doming tray and apply resin. Here you see how slow I actually am in applying this resin to take care that it doesn't run over the edge. Now we'll speed it up. I'm applying a small amount around the entire top edge. This will give me a nice smooth finish. Now the air is still trapped in this little pocket, so I'll use a tiny pointy swab to force the air out and the resin in. And use your mixing wand to get rid of any bubbles. Cover these up and let them set for another 12 hours. Let's see how they turned out. This piece is nice and smooth across the top, but you can see how uneven the graphic is. I still love it. And this one is completely uneven, but you can see the effect that you'd have. Make sure that your strips are 5/8 inch. And you can see how the light reflects across them and through them. This one looks completely different in the sun than it does with indoor lighting. I'll peel off that little strip, and you'll see the surface is nice and smooth, and that crater is gone. Here's some extreme color shift. From indoor lighting to outdoor lighting, look how bright and colorful it is in the sun, and the light passes right through. See how this color shifts from wearing it on bare skin to having a black sleeve behind. So the light around you is going to make a big difference in how this looks, and the colors you put behind it will too. Look at how the rainbow texture film shines through the black background. And look how the colors shift in this piece. It's got copper reflections, and purple and pink and green and orange. The light where you are and the colors you put behind it completely shift the colors of each one of these bangles. I love them all. Come get your supplies at littlewindows.com and let me know how yours turn out.